How do I remove things from my outlook.com account without losing them? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. In recent months, Microsoft basically really confused us and set up some annoying limitations on the amount of space we have available to us in our outlook.com email account. This applies to Outlook.com, Hotmail, Live, whatever email address you happen to be using where you go to Outlook.com to access your email. Basically, they've combined in some screwy way the amount of space you're using on OneDrive with the amount of space that you're using for your attachments and stuff in Outlook.com. Unfortunately, there's no way to just delete an attachment in Outlook.com. You have to delete the entire mail. And a lot of times, what we want to do is we actually want to save that stuff. So what I'm going to do is walk you through a process that will allow you to download your email to your PC, move the emails that you want to save out of Outlook.com, thereby freeing up the space, but still keeping the emails and their attachments on your PC. Let's go through that. So here you can see, this is my example account. I'm certainly not bumping up against any size limitations. I've got 3 messages in my inbox and 175 in my archive. But the bottom line here is that it doesn't really matter. The techniques that we're going to use here apply regardless of how much email you happen to have stored. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and minimize that for now, because what I'm going to do instead is fire up a browser, any browser will do, and I'm going to search for Thunderbird. The technique that we're using here basically has you installing a third-party email program, I'm going to use Thunderbird for that, and set up a download of your email using that third-party email program. So we'll go ahead and open Thunderbird setup. At this point, I'm done with the browser, so I'll go ahead and close that. Thunderbird, of course, would like permissions to play on my device, and we'll walk through setting it up. Always choose custom. I don't think Thunderbird does anything, surprising or hidden, but I'm going to walk through that anyway. The maintenance service, this is what allows Thunderbird to periodically check for updates, regardless of whether or not you're actually running the program. Create icons. Again, this is totally up to you. I'm going to go ahead and let it throw something on my desktop so that we can see it there later. And of course, it should always show up in your start menu. Thunderbird as my default email program. This is up to you. Honestly, I kind of recommend it. If you don't already have a third-party email program installed, setting up Thunderbird as the default is a fine thing to do. It makes a couple of things easier later. So it's been installed. That's it. We're going to go ahead and launch Thunderbird right now. Now, this is where we configure Thunderbird. It doesn't have any accounts configured yet, but we're going to configure it for the email account that I was showing you in the email program I was just running. So I'm going to go ask Leo example at hotmail.com. And like I said, this can be any email address that is serviced by Outlook.com. So if Outlook.com is where you go to read your email, then the email address you put in here is whatever that email address is for you. I need to come up with a password for this. We'll type remember password so that we don't have to continually type the password in every time we want to use this. And we'll hit continue. Now, in this case, Thunderbird knows all about Hotmail and Outlook.com. So it's actually set up a default configuration for how we will want this program to access it. In this case, what's important, regardless of whether or not your email program does this automatically or not, is that you use IMAP. IMAP allows you to access your email online without changing your email online. If you choose POP3, all of your email will be downloaded to your PC and removed from online. That's not what we want. IMAP gives you essentially a view on all of your email, where you can pick and choose what lives where, what's going to be deleted. So IMAP is great. There's my username, and we'll just hit done. Now, this is a very important consideration. Unable to log in. The issue here is that this email account has two-factor authentication turned on. And Thunderbird does not have a way to make two-factor authentication happen. So what I'll be doing off the video is creating what's called an app password. That is a password that I will use specifically for this installation. It will not be a password that works anywhere else, and it'll be a password, not something that I choose, but something that I'm given by Microsoft. So we'll come right back for that. Okay, so I've created an app password. I'm going to paste that in here to my password field instead of the password that I had pasted in earlier, and I'll hit continue. And there we go. We're configuration found. We're all set up. We are done. The account has been successfully created, and you'll see that here in the next tab. It automatically shows all of the folders we have associated with this account online. And if we take a look at the inbox, we'll find that, yep, there are those three messages. Now, this is key. Those messages, everything in this askleoexample@hotmail.com subsection are associated with that account, and they are all stored online. In addition to being available here and stored on my computer, they are also being stored online. They're taking up space online. What we want is something on this PC only that we can save email in without it taking up space online. And as the name implies, that's what local folders are all about. So I'm going to go to local folders. I'm going to right click on local folders, and we're going to create a new folder. I'm going to call this Ask Leo Example Saved Items. You can call it whatever you want. There's a folder now, and it's got nothing in it. If I now go to my inbox and simply drag and drop one of these messages, like here's a message that happens to be a copy of my most recent newsletter, I'm going to click on it, drag it, and drop it down to this local folder. Now, two things have happened. One, the message is now in the local folder. There it is. But more importantly, the message is no longer in the account online. And in fact, if I fire up and go to the other email interface, it's gone. It's not here. If I go to outlook.com online, that message is gone. In fact, I don't think it even shows up in deleted items. It has been removed completely from the account, which means it's no longer taking up space. The message that we just moved is no longer in my Outlook.com account. Therefore, it is no longer taking up space. However, over here in Thunderbird, the message still exists in this local folder. That's how you can save your email that you have stored online by copying it locally and moving it into a folder that is specifically and only on this PC. Now, remember, it's specifically and only on this PC, which means it's not backed up. The good news here, of course, is that if you are backing up your PC regularly, as you should be, then everything in Thunderbird will be getting backed up as well. On the other hand, if you're not, you're going to want to take some steps to make sure that whatever you have here is also being backed up somewhere else. Again, my strong recommendation is that you set up a regular image backup of your entire PC, because if you don't have that, everything on your PC is at risk of being lost. But the good news here is that if you do that, all of this will also be backed up. That will save you a fair amount of space in your Outlook.com account and could potentially allow you to get back under that annoying Outlook.com, OneDrive.com quota issue. I hope that helps you solve this problem. If you've got questions, if you have issues, be sure and visit askleo.com/162683. You'll find updates and related links and comments. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.